As we get older, we slow down and we do less. And as our muscles get weaker, it gets harder for us to do things. And so we don't really want to do those things. And we become more sedentary. To do planned and structured physical activity, we call exercise, targets sort of these weakness areas for individuals. There's a movement across Canada right now to try and educate people about the importance of doing exercise, because exercise is probably the most potent pharmaceutical agent that we know of.
This could be the elixir, the fountain of youth that we have all been searching for. It is no secret that Canada as a country, we're getting older and we are getting sicker. We need a way to offset what is happening to our growing aging population. And I firmly believe that resistance training and multi-component exercise is the method that will help us do that. In terms of the actual resistance training, it's just really an area that hasn't been focused on enough, I feel, especially from an intensity perspective, really pushing older adults to what they are capable of.
Our research is to combat a problem that often many people know about, but it's hard to describe it actually happening, and that is frailty. And frailty is really the accumulation of different disease conditions, and disability, and loss of physical function that leads to a point where a person no longer can cope or thrive within their normal environment. The idea behind this research study is to engage them in an exercise program that is tailored to their level of frailty. They could be pre-frail or frail. We feel that this is a good group to target because they're not yet lost their mobility and they can still attend a program that will be effective for them. And so this is why the idea of bringing them to do a multi-component exercise program that highlights the facts of doing resistance exercise training and balance training to prevent falls and to increase their awareness and ability to be more active. And so it's all about reversing the frailty symptoms. The goal is to now have a platform or exercise platform where we can train other fitness trainers who run exercise classes for older adults to be aware of the frailty condition and then have knowledge about what kinds of exercises can be most effective at reversing the condition. And then from this trial that we're doing, will we allow people to realize that these are the most effective ways, we hope, and be more effective in their own exercise classes for older adults.
What we are finding is that you can push these older adults a lot harder than what we initially believed. And in order to reverse that pre-frail and frailty status, that is exactly what it's going to take.
It's important that this information is not only going to the kinesiologists, but also to the physiotherapists and occupational therapists, nurses, massage therapists, physicians. And this is a messaging and information that's going to be effective for them. And that's where our current research paper has led us to in terms of these clinical recommendations for exercise in frailty.